How can big AAA games keep their NPCs interesting and interactive when there are hundreds of them, and especially after multiple encounters? Anyone who played Hogwarts Legacy knows what I'm talking about. The lack of dialogue variety hurts the experience and quickly turned into a meme. Hello everyone, welcome back, or welcome if you're new here. In today's video, we are gonna take a look at Ghostwriter, the newest Ubisoft in-house AI tool for NPCs dialogue generation. Ubisoft announced that they will be using the AI Ghostwriter tool to write dialogues for some of its games, to keep their NPCs more interesting and realistic without so much manual work. This doesn't mean that video game writers are gonna lose their jobs. Instead, it means that it's going to decrease the task load of writing individual phrases and sounds made by NPCs during certain events.
Hey there.
Hello, sir.
Some game developers took to social media, calling for the company to invest in human writers instead. Ubisoft replied in a tweet, noting that the tool was created in collaboration with writers and is simply about creating more variations for short lines for NPCs. These little things are essential for player immersion in games. NPCs talking to each other, running their own errands, and interacting and reacting to your character's presence makes the game feel alive.
What the hell?
And unfortunately, when what they say is too repetitive, at some point you just start to ignore them. In any case, writing each line takes time and effort from script writers that could be spent on other more important plot lines. The tool is used to generate background lines and barks, and not cinematic or lore content. Ben Swanson is the creator of Ghostwriter. He presented this tool at the Game Developers Conference 2023 that took place last month in San Francisco, California. In his talk, he presented how the tool works and how it's used by Ubisoft. He compared the tool process to rolling a 30,000-sided die that references to words, and then having a software that checks which word that number that you got corresponds to. The dice is rolled over and over to build a sentence, and based on sample datasets, it puts the words in a functional order. Ghostwriter can generate lines based on a character's mood or situation. It can create dialogues between NPCs or between the player, the character, and its companion NPC. It can also, for example, create a large amount of lines for crowds. And Ubisoft games are known for those big crowds. And when players walk through them, they can hear pieces of conversations or remarks about what's happening in the game world or plot. And most importantly, Ghostwriter is used to create paraphrases of barks. In other words, different variations of the same sentence. For example, I am tired, I'm sleepy, I'm going to bed, and so on. And these generated lines can also be set to strict or to random, creating iterations that are more similar or varied. A writer using Ghostwriter would start by creating a character and then specifying what kind of dialogue they want to generate based on personality or situation. For example, happy at the bank, or actually irritated at the bank, happy at the bakery, and sad at the church, and so on. The AI then generates a bunch of variations that the writer can choose and manually edit. Ben said, and I quote, "Rather than writing first draft versions themselves, Ghostwriter lets script writers select and polish the samples generated. Ghostwriter needs human input and feedback, however. Once the writers get the results, they can accept, reject, or edit them, and this feedback data is then returned to the machine learning algorithm that is going to return better results afterwards. Now, tools like Ghostwriter typically incorporate several machine learning algorithms, such as natural language processing and deep learning. NLG can be compared to the process humans use to turn ideas into writing or speech. Of course, we don't have access to Ghostwriter's codebase as it's not an open source tool, but instead an in-house software developed by Ubisoft. but we do have an idea of how it probably works behind the scenes. The NLG process to generate text includes 6 stages. First, content determination to decide what information to mention in the text. Second, document structuring to determine what information comes first or second in the sentence. Third is aggregation to merge similar sentences or related information to improve readability. Four, lexical choice to choose the best word to explain a certain content. 5. Referring expression generation to pick, for example, the best pronouns. And finally, realization, or creating the text itself, which should be correct according to syntax, morphology, and orthography.
Morphology, phonology, syntax.
Now, there is an alternative to natural language generation that doesn't require all these separated stages, and that would be to use end-to-end machine learning to build the system. Meaning we create a natural language generation system by training a machine learning algorithm using large data sets as input and corresponding human-written text outputs. The end-to-end approach has been the most successful in image captioning. Another big part of Ghostwriter is deep learning. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning that attempts to simulate the behavior of the human brain, allowing it to learn from large amounts of data. Deep learning drives many AI applications, and it's the technology behind many everyday products and services, like digital assistants, voice-enabled devices, and even self-driving cars. But the biggest application using deep learning that I can think of is GPT-3, or Generative Pre-trained Transformer 3. No. Not that type of transformer. The GPT-3 language prediction model is the model created by OpenAI, used by ChatGPT. In my opinion, this approach is just great. It supports the company's employees in their current tasks without having to just hire more and more employees for a specific project just to see them out from the company again once the project is done. And cycles like this of quick hiring and layoffs are turning into something common nowadays for tech companies, as we see high turnover near the start and the end of a project or a game in the case. But this is not healthy for the employee or the company, as it's gonna be seen by the employee or by anyone who is looking for a job as a high-risk company. And suddenly that company doesn't look that attractive anymore, does it? Still, there's a lot of controversy. For example, how much time would it take to analyze all the outputs of this tool? Maybe it's the same time that it takes to write all the lines for the dialogues, you know, manually. But that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I was able to shed some light on this topic. Let me know in the comments, what are your thoughts about this tool? Do you think people are gonna lose their jobs? Do you think the tool is just gonna make their jobs easier? Do you think nothing is gonna happen? I'm dying to know what your opinion on this matter is. Please give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Consider subscribing to the channel. And thank you again for watching. And I see you guys in the next one. Bye!